voice of the Lord makes the deer give birth, and strip the forest bird, and in his temple everyone says,
the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, for he has anointed me to preach the gospel. It is the revelation you have of God that brings the manifestation of God. When the kingdom of God comes in your life, it comes with power. I make a prophecy, as you open your heart to embrace the kingdom of God, God will add a job to it. You don't serve a dead God, you serve a mighty God. He's the same yesterday, he's the same today, he's the same forever. God is on your side, power is on your side, grace is on your side, fire is on your side, God is on your side. Lift your hand and shout, yeah, yeah.
Voice of Glory with Prophet Calvin.
Romans chapter 8 verse 19. Earnest expectation of the creature waited for the manifestation of the sons of God. Verse 20, see that. For the creature was made subject to vanity, not willingly, but by reason of him who had subjected the same in hope. Verse 21. Because the creature itself also shall be delivered from the bondage of corruption into the glorious liberty of the children of God. Into the glorious liberty. We love you, Lord, you are holy, and forever
you are God.
I trust you, Lord, you are mighty, and forever you are God. Oh, we bless you, Lord, you are mighty, you are mighty, oh. The manifestation of the sons of God. Tell somebody, are you a child of God? Then you must manifest. Now, where we read from, I love it so much, so much. Do you love it too? Are you sure? He said, the endless expectation of the creation. It means everything that God has created, he said, is crying. The Bible says groaning. What is the meaning of the word groaning? To groan means to weep profusely. To groan means to cry. He said, the whole world and everything God has created is crying. Why? Because they are expecting God's children to manifest. And Abba explains to us that the reason why they are groaning is because the creation is in bondage. You see what? He said, but by the manifestation of the sons of God, they shall be brought into the glorious liberty of God's children. Now, just the phrase, not liberty, glorious liberty of the children of God. There is no such a thing as bondage to a child of God. If you are in bondage, how will you bring them into liberty? A man in prison cannot organize bail for another prisoner. Am I saying the truth? Into the glorious liberty. He said, the creator, your nation, your village, everything around you is in pains. Why? Because, oh, Satilo Hoshata, when God created Adam, God gave Adam authority over all the work of his hands. Psalm chapter 8 from verse 5, he said, you made man ruler of the work of your hands. It means everything God created, he gave to man to rule. Are you with me? Now, when Satan came and spoke to Adam, when Adam accepted what Satan said, because whom you obey becomes your master. If you obey God, who is your master? Now, don't be deceived. If you obey Satan, he becomes your master. It means ownership is by service. It is who you serve that owns you. No matter what you confess, if you serve Satan, he's your master. And service to Satan is obedience to him. God said, don't eat from the tree. Satan said, eat from the tree. Now, the one whom you choose to do proves your master, because how do we prove our service? By our obedience. The one who Adam obeyed is the one whom he served. As long as Adam obeyed God, God was his master. But when Adam obeyed Satan, he did not know that obedience is synonymous of submission. Whom you obey is whom you submit yourself to. Whether you know or not, as immediately you obey the devil, you have submitted yourself to him as his servant or his slave. That's what the Bible stresses in Romans chapter 6 from verse 12 to 14. He said, do not be slaves of sin, but become slaves of righteousness. Are you getting me at all? So, when Adam obeyed the devil, who became his master? The devil. You cannot obey Satan and still remain under God. You can never. The things we do are symbolic of who we serve. And whom we serve is an expression of who is our master. So when Adam fell, don't forget that God had placed everything under whose hands? Somebody say Adam. So when Adam fell, everything under Adam fell alongside with him. It's not just man who fell. No. Every creation of God. Immediately Adam came under Satan. Adam and everything that Adam was to rule came under him. For example, the Bible says there was war in heaven. And angel Michael and his angels fought. And Satan and his angels fought. When Satan was cast down, he didn't come there alone. All the angels that were in his battalion, they came down with him. Because all those who are under you, they are subjected to whatever happens to you. That's why he said, I will strike the shepherd and the sheep will scatter. Because if I touch the shepherd, everything under him will face the same consequence. Am I speaking something here? That's why the most important thing in a body is the head. Are you with me? So, when Adam fell, everything was subject to bondage. Animals were no longer in their place. Animals were not meant to be killing man and eating man. So he said, from the time Adam fell, the world has been in what? In a bondage. But something happened. If you remember, the Bible says, when God was speaking to Adam, when God told the serpent, you will eat the dust, God came to Adam. The Bible says, and the Lord cursed the ground. So the ground was not cursed. He said, cursed shall be the ground. Are you seeing now? What is that? A curse is a bondage. So the earth came under a curse because of Adam's mistake. Because Adam was the ruler of the earth. So when God did not curse Adam, he cursed the ground. God will not curse his child. So when he cursed the ground, from that time to now, every other thing has been under bondage. So he says, this creation has been awaiting the day they will be set free from the power of Satan. Ladies and gentlemen, fire is not bad. Neither is fire good. It depends who is using it. People use a knife to cook. Some use a knife to kill. So the things that God made were now used by Satan to communicate evil. The things that were meant for good. Are you following me at all? So everything came under the power of Satan. That is why you notice that they are witch doctors and some form of herbalists that can do some strange miracles. They use leaves, some things, create some things. Why? They are using the power of these things negatively. People use leaves and poison people. But the Bible is telling us the good news. It says, so this world has been crying. Your village has been crying. Cameroon has been crying. Waiting for what? The manifestation of the sons of God. Because the only way they will be set free is when we manifest. They will keep crying to somebody manifest, child of God. The worst is if they are crying. and there's nobody to manifest. He said, they shall be set free and brought into the glorious. The glorious liberty. Glorious, enviable liberty of God's children. But what a shock that when you see children of God today, instead to see glory, we see shame. What a shock. Your village is waiting to enjoy the freedom you enjoy in Christ. But funnily, you are in Christ, but you are crying more than them. Can I pray for you? May you grow up in the name of Jesus. Please sit down. Say, I must manifest. Say it louder. To manifest means to show forth. To do what? To manifest means to show forth. To show forth or to bring out what is inside. I'm teaching you something very important now. A man cannot show forth what is not in him. So to manifest means what? To show forth or to bring out what is inside. You are the light of the world. He said, fine, but don't stop there. Let the light in you so shine. That means to manifest. That men will see. It means when we speak of manifestation, is what people see from us. So every time we speak of manifestation, there must be a visibility. To manifest means to show forth or to bring out what is inside. And to manifest also means to expose. If there is something in us, okay, greater is he that is in us. He should not stay in you. You should manifest to the world. The world will never know the greater one in you till you manifest and the world sees. Ladies and gentlemen, we are in the times when people openly, publicly, even on TV, they doubt the existence of God. And they give you examples. People come on their TV, take 4 hours just to debate that Jesus is not Lord. People speak about how other gods are better. People are no longer ashamed. Even Christians, they sit down on TV and they twist the word of God. And they begin to tell people how somebody say, I am a Christian gay. It's my own inclination. And other Christians cannot speak. Why? No manifestation. No manifestation. Ladies and gentlemen, nothing puts an end to oppression as a manifestation. Wherever there is oppression, it can only be silenced by a manifestation. How do I know this? Study Exodus chapter 3 from chapter 2, chapter 12. Moses, the Bible says, and the children of God were under the oppression of who? Of Pharaoh in Egypt. When it was time for God to set them free, they did not just go free. What happened? God had to manifest himself. He said, Moses, Pharaoh will not let you go unless by a mighty hand. So the first reason why we must manifest is to put an end to oppression. If there is no manifestation, oppression will be there. When the ungodly rule the city, say the people are how? He said, but when the righteous lead, the people rejoice. The people are a reproach. It is easy to complain about things, but what we complain about don't change what we manifest. So after all the oppressions, after all the way God Pharaoh oppressed the people of Egypt, when God manifested himself through Moses, they went out. It means oppression could only come to an end by a manifestation. If you check 1 Samuel chapter 17, there was a man called Goliath. Goliath was oppressing the people of Israel for 40 days, day and night. And the Bible specifically says, nobody could go out or come in. How did that oppression stop? By the manifestation of God through who? David. There are certain things we don't like in our families. They will not change because we cry. They will only change when we manifest. They will only change when we show forth what we have inside. some things will only stop happening to somebody who says enough is enough. When David came to the war front and he looked at Goliath and he got angry in his spirit. Remember, David was not a soldier. He was a shepherd. He was sent to the war front to give bread to his brothers who were soldiers. But he went to the war front and the king was hiding. His brothers were hiding. And David said to himself, who is this uncircumcised Philistine to challenge the army of God? And they asked him, what have you come to do here? For what? He looked at his brother and said, is there not a reason? Come on, seven brothers, all still staying with their father. None has built a house. And David is 17, means the first one is about 30. None is married. And David said, is there not a reason? Look at how you are at your age. I should stay quiet. So the mistake we make in church is that we think, ladies and gentlemen, let the world complain, not us. We are the light. If us who are the light are saying things are dark, how dark is that darkness? If your family complains, he said, no, they are complaining because they are waiting for your manifestation. Genesis chapter 2 verse 5 says, and the Lord put seed in the earth, but the Lord did not send rain because there was no man to walk the earth. Rain speaks of the blessing. He says, there are families that God will not send rain until there is a man to walk the earth. Why? Because when rain comes, a man has to till the earth for the seed to receive the rain and flourish. He said, and the Lord had not sent rain. Reason, there was no man to till the earth. There was no man to walk. Jezebel oppressed more than 20,000 prophets and they all ran to Elijah came forth. The end of Jezebel is in the manifestation of Elijah. The end of Goliath is the manifestation of David. The end of Herod is in the manifestation of the church of Christ. When they arrested Peter and kept him in prison, the church prayed. The next day, Herod died. Herod was an oppressor. When the church was complaining, they killed James. They cut his head. James died. Are you getting me at all? Manifestation does what? It puts an end to oppression. It puts an end. It puts an end. If they complain, we can't complain. If they talk, we can't talk. They talk because they don't have. Acts chapter 3, verse 1 to 7. It says, there was a man that was carried daily, and he was put at a gate called Beautiful to beg. And the man was lame. Is it from birth? Well, I don't know. But he was lame for a long time, maybe from birth. Watch this. One day, so the man has been begging for more than 30 years. Peter and John were coming to the temple to pray, and they saw the man who was begging. After having begged from people, he came to Peter. He said, sir, I need money. Something, something well up in Peter. Peter looked and said, this is oppression. Peter said, was I not there when Jesus was crucified on the cross? Was I not there when Jesus said, it is finished? Why is this man still sick? He said, this is an oppression. Satan will not leave you because Jesus died. Don't even be deceived. He will not leave you because you are under a prophetic grace. Jesus told Apostle Paul, I am with you. The next day, 40 men banded themselves to kill him after a prophetic revelation. Are you getting me at all? And Peter looked at the man, he said, silver and gold I don't have, but what I have, bring it forth. What I have, give I to you. In the name of Jesus the Nazarene, rise up and walk. Bible says, and listen, you see, when the man stood up, the first thing he did, he entered the temple. It means that man had always desired to worship God. But since he was a beggar, he was at the mercy of his carrier. People will always leave you where they want to leave you. In the journey of life, if you let a man be your driver, you will end where he chooses. The guys will carry him, leave him at the gate, and they enter temple and worship God. Why did they not bring him inside, knowing that there is God's presence? For where the spirit is, there is liberty. They better leave a man outside. When the man says, I have been longing to enter, but I have been oppressed, a man's feet, when a man is lame, it means his speed in life has been tampered. And your feet speaks of your possession. Wherever the soles of your feet shall tread upon, you shall possess. So the man could not enter his inheritance. He did not have speed because he was lame. And when he was healed, he entered the church. But this man could not receive that miracle till Peter and John manifest what is in them. They could have passed and given him money. Trust me, they had money. They had money. Yes, they had it. He said, I have money, but not to give you what I have. I saw a vision of the Lord, and I saw people sick, oppressed, dirty. And I said, Lord, help them. And God said, Kevin, help them. And I said, how? He said, all they need is the ageless, timeless, eternal, ever abiding word of God. Preach in his simplicity. For I have made you into a rock, out of which rivers of healing will flow. If you honor my word, I will honor your word and use it to heal them. So when I'm standing on the prayer line and I see somebody sick, I'm thinking only one thing: this oppression must end. That's why, no matter what happens, no matter where I'm going to, I have never seen a sick person and I passed. It can't happen. Even I am tired from church, how? I will never see oppression and I go. I remember in 2012 when I was praying, and about some angels entered my room, and the chief angel said to me, you were sent for the liberation of many from the shackles of sin, poverty, sickness, and darkness. For the liberation. So if somebody is sick, I've been anointed to liberate them. A manifestation.
Voice of Glory with Prophet Calvin.
Seen those with HIV being healed, those with cancer being healed, but they could be sick and I come and cry with them, but I have chosen not to cry. I have cried in the past, but I've realized he has not helped them. So I went and prayed. I said, Lord, empower me to help your people. Don't be dreaming. Jesus will not come down. He's coming down only for rapture. Jesus shall not come back to heal the sick. He's coming to take the church. Have you not read scripture? Oppression. Strong men don't go down to a stronger man stands up. Let's not cry. Let's manifest. Am I speaking to somebody here? Number two, manifestation silences accusation. No matter what people say about you, it's your manifestation that will prove who you really are. We live in a time where people are misunderstood, people are misquoted. Unless they manifest, it will continue. It silences what? Accusation. But I want to show you something there. He said, who will manifest? First thing you should know, principles of manifestation. Manifestation is only for sons of God. It's only for sons. Sonship qualifies a man to the inheritance of heaven. Once God makes you his son, he has qualified you to receive the spirit. Or you have been made the son by the spirit by the same way. Amen. So, if you are not a child of God, please forget about manifestation. And also, if you are a child of God and you are not manifesting, is a proof that you don't know what it means to be a child of God. The kingdom of God is not a touristic site. We are not saved to be looking at the kingdom of God. When God saves a man, the man is called to be a partaker, not a spectator. God has not called you to be looking. He has called you to be doing. Blessed are they that believe in me, for they shall do. Do manifest. If they see the sick, they heal them. The oppressed, they deliver them. They shall do. Are you with me? So it is a pity to be a child of God and you are not manifesting, because you have been caged by the spirit of fear. What if I pray? I does not get healed. That is not your challenge. Your own is to pray. His own is to heal them. They shall lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. You don't make them recover. He makes them recover. You lay your hands. Are you hearing what I'm saying at all? Manifestation is for sons of God. What a privilege the Father has given us to manifest. Hear this. God manifested himself to us through Jesus Christ. It means Jesus is the manifestation of God. But can I shock you? God manifests himself to the world through the church, not through Jesus Christ. We in the church, we see Jesus. The world sees the church. Am I making any sense here? Jesus. Unto man, Jesus is the manifestation of God. Unto God, Jesus is the manifestation of man. So when God sees Jesus, he sees us. When we see Jesus, we see God. But if the world wants to see God or Jesus, they see us. That's what he said. You shall not see me again until you say, blessed is he that comes in the name of the Lord. It means you will see the Lord when you accept those that come in his name. Sons are called to manifest, not to complain, not to talk, to manifest. For they are those in whom the spirit has been deposited. Who are the sons of God? Number one, a son of God is somebody who has been born of God. Someone say born of God. John chapter 1 verse 10 says it. As many as received him, even to those that believe in his name, what did he do? Power for what? Power to have a car? Power to have a job? Please shout it out. Power for what? Power for what? If those that received him and believe in his name, he gave them the power to become sons of God. Not the power to have a job. It means, once a man believes in God, he receives the spirit that makes him a child of God. And verse 13, John chapter 1 verse 13 says, sons not born of the flesh, nor born of blood, but born of God. Amen. It means, when I say a son of God is somebody who is born of God, it means the man's life is no longer traced to him, to his father, but to his God. Watch this. Leviticus 17:11 says, the life of a creature is in his blood. It means every human being receives life from blood. That's why your father gives you blood. Amen. But a child of God, his life is not in his blood. His life is in the spirit. For they that are led by the spirit, they are the sons of God. Not those who have the spirit, who are led by their blood. Now, this means, I love this so much, when we speak of a child of God, we speak of a person who has received the Spirit of God. God is his Father. When Jesus arose from the dead, the first thing he said, behold, John 20:17, I go to your Father and my Father, and I go to your God and my God. It means Jesus was saying, even after his resurrection, that I came for one reason. I came to give you the right to call God Father. Unless you receive this, you will be chasing vanity. Everything a man needs is in the understanding of his position as a son. If you don't understand what it means to be a son, you will be a son of God, but you will be experiencing the life of a dog. Don't forget, the son sits on the table and eat the bread. but the dogs eat the crumbs that fall from the bread. But there are many sons today eating the crumbs from the bread because they don't know who they are. Because in the kingdom of God, it is knowledge and understanding that makes a man enjoy. Are you getting me at all? To be born of God means to be born from above. It means to be what? To be born from where? So we say a man is born of God. It means the man is born from above. In John chapter 3 verse 31, John said, he that is from above is above all. He said, he who is of the earth speaks as one of the earth. But he who is from above is above how many? So when we say a man is born of God, he's born above the reach of the troubles of this world. In other words, for example, a man, if a man has a sickness like HIV, it is very possible that his child may have HIV. But when a man is born of God, he is born above all these human connections. The things that affect humans don't affect him, because his life does no longer depend on his blood. Ladies and gentlemen, every sickness which touches a man has to do with his blood. But when a man is born of God, he is now born of the Spirit. He gave them the power to get married, to become. If you have not yet become, if you have not yet become, he said, even to those that believe in his name, the power to become. We are called to become. Somebody say, become. If you have not become, then you are not yet there. To become. You are not called to be a believer. Believing is to become a son of God. Heaven is not for believers. Heaven is for sons of God. Are you getting what I'm saying? It's good to be a believer, but better to become a son of God. We believe for a reason. We believe to become. The sons of God are those who are born of God. Those who are born from above. Now, what are the characteristics of sons of God? I'll rush over this. Number one. Sons of God are those that have the nature of God. 2 Peter chapter 1 verse 3 says, it says, we have been, by these precious promises, we have been given the ability to partake of the divine nature. Sons of God, characteristics of sons of God. Now here is, every father, the first thing he gives to his child is his nature. If your father is a dog, you will be a dog. It means nobody decides his nature. Your nature is decided by your father. It is the root that determines the fruit. That's what the Bible says in Romans chapter 11 verse 17. If the root is holy, so are the what? Branches. It means the branch does not determine its state. The state of the branch is dependent upon the roots of that tree. Let me show you something now. If the root is holy, how are the branches? Watch this now. It means, take a man that was a thief, take a girl that was a prostitute, when she comes into Christ, because Christ is holy, she is holy. Oh, that's Asia. So you don't change your nature as a branch, because he said it is the vine that supports the branch. If the root is holy, the branch is holy. So the first thing that a child of God has is that a child of God has the nature of God. What is the nature of God? Righteousness. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Get his kingdom, you get his nature. The reason why God cannot lie is because he's righteous. You can take power from God, he's still God. If you take righteousness from God, he has become Satan. The difference between God and Satan is righteousness. Are you with me? So a child of God possesses the nature of God. It does not matter who you have been in the world. Once you come into Christ, you are made holy by the roots. For it is the root that sanctifies the branch. The only challenge you will have is if as a branch you don't bear fruit, they will cut you off. But it is for your man. Holiness is an expression of righteousness. Holiness is not wearing a ring or not wearing a tie, or wearing a tie, not wearing a ring, not wearing trouser. That's not holiness. That's a dress code. That's a good moral standard. When we speak of holiness, we speak of the expression of the nature of righteousness. Watch this. There is something that produces fruit. It is called sap. It is called what? What is it called?
Sap.
What is it called?
Sap.
Sap is produced in the roots, channeled in the vine to the branches. In the branches, it's like blood. It's like the blood of a tree. Watch this now. What makes the branch produce fruit is the sap. In other words, once we come into Christ, the Holy Spirit begins to flow in us, and his flow into us sanctifies our very being. Am I speaking to somebody here? It means once you are a child of God, you don't need to be Zahashiko Banazi. Whoever is born of God is above all. Watch this now. You need to understand that it is your nature that determines your environment. A fish must remain in water because of his nature. Fish, this place where we breathe air and we are happy, if you bring a fish here, he will die. Why? His nature has not given him the ability to survive here. Birds fly, nature. You try and fly. Try. Birds don't fly because they have wings. If I'm lying, ask the cock. He has been trying to fly since. If you don't ask him, ask the ostrich. He also has wings. Birds fly because of their nature. There's something God put in them that gives them the ability to fly. Am I speaking here? Righteousness qualifies a man for a blessing. Sin qualifies a man for curse. It means once you are born of a human being, you are already under a curse. Why? Your nature. When Jesus came, John 1:21, John the Baptist said, "Behold, the Lamb of God that takes away the sin of the world." Not the sins with S, the sin. What is the sin of the world? The sin of the world is what Adam committed in the Garden of Eden. Everything we experience flows from the mistake of Adam. So Jesus came to redeem the world from the sin Adam committed. And because of that sin, everyone is born with a sinful nature. That's what the Bible says. And Jesus became sin, not became a sinner. Became sin that we might become, not that we may become righteous. We may become the righteous, the definite article. We may become the righteousness of God. What does that mean? When God made Adam, you know, when Adam sinned, what happened? What did God say? Adam, where are you? For all have sinned and fallen short. That scripture was written when we were not born. So when did we sin? Bible says, for all sinned in Adam. If all sinned in Adam, all have been justified by the obedience of Christ. Romans 5:17. Take 14, 15, 16, 17. It means you don't owe Shiko Brazil Hina Suja Katija. Am I preaching to you here? Say, I have the nature of God. Now, when you understand this nature, you will not be afraid of the things you see. Because your nature determines your lifespan. Is that true? A fowl will not live for 100 years. Even if he's not sick, one day he will die. Because there is an age limit for his nature. Now the Bible now says, you who is born of God is born from above. It means he has a superior nature that is not subject to the laws of this kingdom. Man, Jesus passed through a wall and they said he was a spirit. He said, okay, give me bread, let me eat. Spirits don't eat. He ate bread to prove to them that I am superior to the laws of your kingdom. You guys don't walk on water. Come on. Moses opened water. He was not a son of God. He was a man of God. He was a servant of God. Elijah opened water. Elisha opened water. But when Jesus came to prove that he is of a superior nature, he walked on water. I said, I don't need to open this. I am for a different way. I prophesy. Where others fail, you will succeed. Where others fall, you will stand. In the name of Jesus. Say, I am from above. I am above all. Sit down. Come on. In the Old Testament, the Bible says in Numbers chapter 21, he said, and snakes bit the people, and the people died. Okay, come to New Testament, and a viper bite Apostle Paul, and he shook it off. We are different. In the time of the people in the Old Testament, when snake bite them, God asked them to look upon another snake to be healed. But when a snake bite Apostle Paul, he did not look upon anything. Psalms 121 says, I shall look upon the hills where my help comes from. But in the New Testament, we don't look upon the hills. For Jesus said, the Holy Spirit shall be in you. So my help does not come from the hill. My help is inside of me. Jesus said, it is not I that do the work, but the Father that lives in me. Not the Father in heaven. Who is the Father in me? The Holy Spirit. Oh, Kazi Pradash. He said, John 14 verse 10. He said, if you don't believe me for the work's sake. For it is not I that doeth the works, but the Father in me. There is a Father in heaven, but there is a Father in you. When it comes to doing the work, it is the Father in you. And the Father in you is symbolic of the presence of the Holy Spirit. So I am not looking upon the hill. I am looking inside of me. There is a Father in me that can do the works. It is not I that heal the sick. It is the Father in me. It is not I that raise the dead. It is the He lives in me. He lives in me. Oh God, come down, come and manifest your power. No, no. Say, Kevin, come here. You don't ask him to come down. He's living inside of me. He's living inside of you. Oh my God. When you walk into a village, Jesus has walked into that village. He said, you will not talk at the super radihasha. Can I prophesy to you? The Father in you will manifest himself. He said, it is the Father in me, not in heaven. When you want to pray, say, our Father who art in heaven. What is that long prayer? But when it came to the works, it's the Father who was in him that doeth the works. Now Jesus talk him. John 14, 10, the Father who is in me, he does the works. Who is the Father in me? What do you have in you? The spirit of fear? The spirit of shame? Once you step to your marketplace, it's because, oh, why are these people like this? Some people think that they have gone to the store and God is in the house or God is in heaven. God is in heaven, but the Father lives in me. So if I step into a car, the Father is there. If I step to my business place, the Father is there. I'm not afraid of what man can do. When people talk to me, I am not the one you have challenged. You have challenged the Father in me. That is why the snake bite Apostle Paul. Apostle Paul shook it in the fire. Snakes cannot kill God. Can I prophesy in the name of Jesus? Because you are a child of God, you are above poverty, you are above affliction, you are above disappointment, you are above oppression. You don't serve a dead God, you serve a mighty God. He's the same yesterday, he's the same today, he's the same forever. When God says yes, the man can say no. When God lifts you up, no man can bring you down. God is on your side. God is in you. Power is in you. Grace is in you. Lift your hands, shout yeah. Shout yeah. Somebody say the Father lives in me. Shout the Father, he lives in me. Shout, thank you, Lord. Sit down.
He did not ask us to pray that God come down and manifest your power. When we are praying that in church, the world is wondering. Because the world should be praying, let the sons of God manifest their power. Not us praying that. Because there is a depth. Kaya si so pasa te so hosh. Hey, ya, 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 ya. For he that is born of God. He said to Nicodemus, a man came. He said, Lord, I know. That's John chapter 3. He said, I know that you are a teacher come from God. For no one can do these signs unless God be with him. And Jesus said to Nicodemus, no one can see the kingdom of God unless he is born again. And Nicodemus said, shall I enter my mother's womb and be born again? And Jesus said, I say unto you, no one can enter the kingdom of God unless he's born of water and the spirit. For the flesh keep dead, but the spirit gives life. He said, and he that is born of God, he is like the wind. You only hear his sound. You don't know where he's going to. He that is born of God is like a wind. Nobody can catch a wind. You don't know where I'm coming from. You don't know where I'm going to. No charm can stop me. No power can stop me. No witch can stop me. Lift your hands, shout, I am born again. Shout it again. Are you hearing what I'm saying? It's like the wind. Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. Hey, 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 hey. Ozikata. Now, Bible. The flesh profited for nothing, but the spirit quickens. He that is born of flesh is flesh. He that is born of spirit is spirit. And this man who is born of the spirit is like the wind. Jesus began to explain to Nicodemus. He said, the man born of God, he said, what can I use? Nicodemus, wait, do you know the wind? Yes. He said, when you are born of God, you have become like the wind. He said, the wind blows where it wishes. It means I go where I want. You can't stop me. There cannot be an hindrance. I do what I want. And he explained again, he now said, you only hear the sound, but you don't know where it is coming from or where it is going to. Can I prophesy in the name of Jesus? No power will be able to arrest you. You only hear the sound. You know, he had to explain to Nicodemus, it's like the wind, because God, okay, the Mahasham, he that is born of flesh is like the dust. God said to Adam, dust you are, and dust you shall return. And God told the serpent, you will eat dust. In other words, he that is born of the flesh is food for the serpent. They said, but he that is born of God is no more dust, is a spirit, is a wind. And serpents don't eat wind. It means the only way to come out from the category of the people that Satan can oppress is not by a night vigil, it's not going to a crusade, it's not by a fasting, it's to become a child of God. If you become a child of God, you cannot be handled by Satan. I prophesy in the name of the Lord, because you are born from above, you will subdue your enemy. Because you are born from above, lift your hands, shout, I shall be 10 times better. Somebody holla, I'm born from above. Sit down. It's like the wind. Hey, sister, you will fail. He said, no one knows where he's going to. Don't claim to know my future. You don't know. Now, Jesus, talk him. The way I'm seeing you, I will not me for. No one, please don't claim to know my future. There are people who tell you the way I'm seeing your life, you will end up as a failure. Say, with all due respect, I am not dust, I am the wind. Nobody knows where I am going to. There is something about dust. When the wind blows, it takes away the dust. But there is something about the wind. If you put a wall like this, the wind will break the wall. Can I make a prophecy? I'm talking about the army of the Lord, the end time army. Bullets will not kill us. Bombs will not kill us. Serpents will not kill us. Lions will not kill us. We are more than conquerors. We carry the nature of God. Apostle Paul
you go, manifest. Wherever you go, manifest.
Can I pray? Oh, yeah. Please, don't claim to know my future. You don't know. Shockingly, you yourself, you don't know your future. So don't think you know. When Samson was born, they told Samson, you see this boy? If you shave his hair, he has lost his power. That's the only thing he knew. That was not the whole secret. So Delilah came and began to entice Solomon. And Solomon said, what I know, if you shave my hair, my power will finish. But he did not know, if the hair grow again, the power will come back. Wait. If he had known, he would have told Delilah, they will not have bathed his hair, they will have bathed his head. So since Delilah did not know, she only shaved the hair. And the Bible says, and Samson stayed, and his hair began to grow again. I don't know where you fell, your hair will grow again. I don't know what you did, your hair will grow again. I prophesy, no matter what Satan knows, he does not know all.
My hair. You know, some of you made mistake and you gave your enemy to you gave your secret to the enemies. I want to tell that there's another secret of your life. You too, you know, be one. if you say God decrees, God not tell you all. You made a mistake. You got pregnant before young. Satan said, if this girl can get pregnant, I have spoiled her life. He does not know her. There is a secret behind the secret. Ladies and gentlemen, when a man called Isaac said he wants to bless Esau, Esau went to the bush and Jacob came to the house and stole the blessing. So when Jacob thought he has stole all the blessing that Isaac has, when Esau came, Esau cried. And I love what Isaac said to Esau. He said, Esau, I have blessed your brother, but the day that you will be angry, you will break his yoke from your neck. Jacob thought he collected the blessing, but Esau collected power. And the Bible says, when Isaac died, Jacob and Esau met. He said, Jacob bowed 7 times. Wait. I visited the blessed now. They blessed Jacob, but he bowed 7 times. It does not matter the mistakes you make. There is something that can still happen. Saul was a murderer. He became an apostle. David was an adulterer. He became the owner of the chair. Abraham slept with Adam. He still brought forth Isaac. Samson slept with Delilah. He still killed the Philistines. I prophesy on you, in the name of the Lord, you will manifest.
Sit down. Number two. Characteristics. Sons are not slaves. Some say they are not slaves. Sons are not what? They are not. Galatians 4 verse 7 says, if you are a son, you are no longer a slave. I like this one. Galatians 5 verse 1. He said, stand firm in the liberty which Christ has given you. And do not allow yourself to be arrested again. Who wants to arrest me? He said, don't allow yourself. He said, God has made you healthy. Don't allow sickness come. Ladies and gentlemen, when you are not in Christ, you are at the mercy, you are at the disposal of satanic arrows. Once a man is in Christ, he chooses who enters his house. Am I speaking to somebody here? So it is possible for you to stand up and say, I declare in this family, nobody will die untimely death. Because it said to Peter, I give you the key of heaven and earth. What you shall bind in heaven shall be bound on earth. Can I prophesy in the name of Jesus? Whatever you shall lose on earth shall
shall be loose in heaven. I prophesy in the name of the Lord, you will manifest.
I am not a slave.
Who is a slave?
It's a man who is forced. Who is forced to do something. In 2 Kings chapter 4, he said a man borrowed money and the man died and the creditors came to take his sons as slaves. But he made a mistake. You cannot take sons of a prophet as slaves because the man was a prophet. It means his sons were like sons of God. When they came to take them as slaves, when they ran to Elisha, there's something Elisha did. Elisha asked the woman to get oil.
What is oil?
The anointing.
Elisha said, if you stay quiet, your sons may become slaves. But as a daughter of the prophet, a child of God, it is time to pray for the prayer of a righteous man. Make a power available. I refuse to be oppressed. How can you come and tell me you have a spiritual husband? Where do you people marry? How can you tell me that a marine kingdom is destroying your marriage? Who gave them that power? How can you tell me that a herbalist made you fail exam? Who gave them that power? Have you not read what the Bible says? There shall be no incantation, there shall be no enchantment against the sons of God, for no weapon formed against you shall prosper. I prophesy by the anointing of God. I pray for you. Any power wanting to put you in slavery, I arrest them.
Lift your hands. Say, by the unction of God, I receive the ability to stand firm. Sit down. Say, I'm not a slave. Number three, sons of God are the heirs of God. H-E-I-R-S. Somebody say heir. Somebody say the heir of God. Sonship qualifies you to enjoy the inheritance. A man rewards his servants but gives his inheritance to his sons. It means Genesis chapter 15 from verse 1 to 5, and the Lord said to Abraham, behold, I am your exceedingly great reward. And Abraham said, oh God, you have been so good to me, you have given me property, but it shall come to pass that a man born in my house whose name is Eliezer, my servant, he shall inherit my property. And God said to Abraham, no, this one shall not inherit your property, but a son born from your body. It means give a reward to Eliezer to thank him for his service, but give your inheritance to your son because he carries your nature. Colossians 1 verse 12, giving thanks to the Father who has qualified us. No, you qualify yourself. You qualify yourself. If it is God who qualified you, the only man who can disqualify you should be bigger than God. Giving thanks to the Father who has qualified us to share in the inheritance of the saints. Who has qualified? A son of God. Okay, Luke chapter 15, verse 10 to 31. The Bible speaks of a child. It said, a man had two sons. The second said, say, Father, share your property into two and give my own part of the inheritance. Please, he did not work for it. An inheritance is what your father has worked for. Once you are a child of God, whatever God has belongs to you. Am I preaching to people here? A woman came to Jesus and said, my daughter is demonically possessed and she needs healing. And Jesus made a statement that unto the ends of time, we will never forget the statement. It is not right to take the bread of the children and give them to the dogs. In other words, one of the privileges to be a child is that bread must be given to you. So he said, the Lord prepares a table before me. On that table there is bread. That is part of the inheritance. And the bread in that account, it speaks of Jesus, it speaks of healing, it speaks of freedom. So there's something I'd like you to understand. A child of God does not beg for your bread because it is his right.
Voice of Glory with Prophet Calvin.
On the knowledge of your rights gives you spiritual aggressivity. A man becomes spiritually violent only when he knows who he is. My back is spinning. Where? Lord, heal me. Once you know who you are, Satan, take your hand off my back. You can never speak like that unto the understanding of who you are in Christ. Until you know who you are, you will just be a beggar in life. We are going to have a company. Bible says silver and gold are mine, is God who settled. The earth is the Lord. He didn't say a Bible. The earth is the, is it in your Bible? The earth is the Lord. That's Psalm 24. And Psalms 115 says, the earth has he given to the sons of men. Has he given to demons? Who gave these people the rights? Our ignorance. When a demon enter your house, it's illegal. I told you, no matter your rank in the Cameroon army, you are nothing in Nigeria. If you enter Nigeria, you are a civilian. Because your rank does not work there. No matter their rank in hell, on earth, they are illegal. If they are illegal, we will repatriate them. And besides, we follow those that believe in my name, they shall cast out. You wake up in the morning, my leg. You say with sickness, how did you enter here? How? Where? How? Cast it out. Send them back to where they come from. Don't be afraid of their face. They are illegal. The earth has he given to the sons of men. It means any demon trying to claim possession over this earth is illegal. If they are illegal, we are police. We will capture Zahisha. Psalms 149. The Bible says, oh, this is one of my best scriptures. He said, a two-double-edged sword shall be in their mouth. And high praises shall be in their mouth, and a two-double-edged sword in their hand to execute judgment. Is it not so there? He said, the written judgment to bind the princes with chains and to bind the kings with fetters of iron. And he said, this honor have all his sins. It means to bind a devil is an honor. To Kaduzi Hasha. Judgment not executed has no benefit. Once you are arguing a land with somebody, when you go to court and the judge says the court belongs to you, the man may not leave the land. But if he does not leave, then somebody will call the police or the bailiff. If the court has said, go out of this land, and you still remain there, the police will take you out. The police does not speak English. They don't speak French. They slap. Can I make a prophecy on your head? Every satanic force arguing your inheritance, contending your inheritance, I release angels to slap them. The Bible says, and an angel slapped Herod on the right ear and he died. You see, and worms came out from him. Can I just prophesy on you in the name of Jesus? He said, sons are the heirs of God. What God has belonged to you. Every satanic force trying to make your life a mockery, I prophesy the judgment that Jesus had over on the cross, I execute it on them. I rebuke sickness. I rebuke poverty. Lift your hands and shout, get up. Yeah. And thou shalt condemn every tongue that rises. Who shall condemn? God. You. Every tongue that rises up in judgment. In other words, sickness, shut up. Poverty, cut into. thou shalt condemn every tongue. Satan is speaking sickness. If it's from your village, Copting Chum. If they come from Douala, Fem Tabush. If they come from America, shut your mouth. If they come from the spirit, Keduze Okupaye. Am I speaking to somebody here? Somebody holla Satan, shut up. Psalms 8 verse 2 says, he has ordained praise in the mouth of babes to silence the voice of the accuser. I did not come to joke. I came to shut their mouth. I shut the mouth of that cause. I shut the mouth of failure. I shut the mouth of sickness. I shut the mouth of poverty. I shut the mouth of oppression. I shut the mouth of affliction. Hebrews 11 from verse 35. He said, by faith, they shut the mouth of lions. I make a prophecy. Every satanic force speaking accusation in your life, shut up.
You have to get a bit a time. I guess you have to change the way you did. They have seen you as a toy, so you have to be speaking differently. From the days of John the Baptist to the days of Kevin the prophet, the kingdom of God suffer violence. The word suffer means permit, and the beautiful, the elegant, the violent. Who are the violent? Those who understand who they are in Christ. The violent are those who will say, Satan, you will not kill my child. The violent are those who will get to hospital, they give them a medical report, and they say, Satan, shut your mouth. My mother will not die untimely death. My father will not die before a time. Who are the violent? The violent is a man like Joshua. There was a place called Jericho. He walked around 7 times, and the wall came down. Who are the violent? The violent is Moses. There was a Red Sea. He stretched his hand, the water opened. Who are the violent? The violent is Elijah. He prayed to God, and fire came down. Who are the violent? The violent is Suleiman. He saw the dead. He brought them back to life. Who are the violent? The violent is T.P. Joshua. He laid his hands on the sick, and they came back to life. Who are the violent? Chris Oyakilome. They preached the word of God, and blind eyes open. Who are the violent? David Oyedepo. Men of substance, men of character. Who are the violent? The violent is Adeboye. Men who pass in a place where they said there was no road, it did not have an accident. Who are the violent? You and I am here to prophesy in the name of the Lord. You will possess your possession. 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 Lift your hands, shout, I receive.